Hello everyone. Today I want to introduce you to the new M36 Parallel Hybrid. It's the very first of its kind in the world when it comes to pumping concrete with zero emissions. I'll show you the components first and then we'll go into operation to see what the machine can do. Now let's start up the Iontron, the new hybrid machine. First the ignition, and then we'll start up the engine. The engine is running and it's all looking good. The handbrake is applied. The neutral position is engaged. And so we'll start the intermediate gearbox. We get the feedback that the intermediate gearbox is activated. Now we need to wait around 8 seconds until the truck engages the right gear. The gear is engaged and now we're ready for operation. The engine is running, the machine is ready for operation, the power takeoff is engaged. Now let's start up the radio system. How about we take a look at the heart of the machine, the control center. Very neat and compact. Here we have our Ergonic 2 facelift control cabinet. We can already activate and deactivate various lights, the support leg lighting, the support leg flashing lights, and, if one is fitted, the hopper fill level sensors as well. Here we have our radio receiver, which is currently lighting up yellow and green, and then on the right we have a flashing LED. That means that we now have a radio link and that we are receiving feedback on our transmitter, so on our radio remote control. At the top we have our centralized gauge port. We can read off the hydraulic pressures here, and the bar is divided. This area is for the high pressure. That can go quite high on ILS machines, including the Iontron, where it can reach 420 bar. Here is the low pressure area, where we can read off the feed pressures, low pressure and so on. This area goes up to 60 bar and the high pressure, as I said, goes up to 420 bar. Our control panel is fitted here. With this control panel we can basically operate the entire pump and can also acknowledge our grill switch. We'll do that now. I'll press this button here. You can see that it was lit up red and blue. Blue means that the button can definitely be operated. Let's just press it. Now you can see that the green LED is lit up, meaning our RFID, so our grill cutout, is acknowledged and safety is now ensured. We can now start the pump. There is a red LED, a green LED and a blue LED here. These are status displays that we provide for the machine operator so that they know what can be operated and what is active. Those kinds of things are displayed here. For example, if I press the button for acknowledging the agitator again, then I get a yellow feedback, meaning, okay, the button was pressed. This red LED means that while I can press the button at the moment, nothing happens. The button is locked. The blue LED means that I can switch on a button, just like the hopper lighting here. The green LED indicates that it's now active. With the green LED, I always know what's up, even when I'm not looking at the relevant part, like at the boom tip or the water box lighting. I know what is switched on and what isn't. Once the green LED is on, the function is also active. Now, let's take a look at the other side. As you can see, we have many more switching elements here. For one, there is the boom control, which really stands out on this side. Here we have the second support leg valve, which is required for monitoring the support leg function. On this machine, We then have a pneumatic valve, which ensures the switchover between driving and pumping operations. At the top here, there is also the EQV valve. This valve, of course, is required to activate the EQV and then let the air escape again. There is also a pressure gauge, which should be set to 3 bar, as a higher pressure than that isn't permitted for the EQV. Our large lubrication reservoir is also called combination lubrication. We have a capacity of 4 liters. With this one lubrication reservoir, we can lubricate the core pump assembly at the rear, so the hopper area, the S-transfer tube shaft bearing, the pressure connection and the agitator. At the same time, we can also lubricate the A-hinge and the 4-point bearing via a changeover valve, a lubricant distributor valve. So with one lubrication reservoir, we can supply 2 important points on our concrete pump. And finally, we also have accessories here. Our machine has been tested quite thoroughly and has been busy pumping already. But underneath, we see another really important part that also sees daily use, the draining mechanism for the hydraulic fluid reservoir. What's important here is to drain the water every day. So it's clear to see that everything is very neatly put away on Putzmeister machines. Everything has its spot, and of course there is enough storage space to stow various other things. There is more than enough space. One special feature of our new Iontron is this fairly large storage compartment on the side here, or at least it looks like a storage compartment. In fact, that's where the control unit for our electric motor is. If you open it here, all you can see is the main switch, and that's all you need for electric mode. Let's take a look inside. A large box and, of course, large control cabinets. It all looks quite big, but it's also very important to ensure the promised power can be delivered in electric mode so that we have a good output. I've now roughly explained the machine, the outside of it, what components are fitted and what the most important points are. Now, let's start the diesel engine and then we'll fold out the support leg. Then we'll unwind the connecting cable together. Right, the swinging support leg is extended. Now we can access the cable quite easily. And then we'll switch the diesel engine off again. The cable isn't exactly lightweight, because we have a 125 amps connector here. So we have hydraulic support for unwinding. The diesel engine needs to be running initially for that. Then we'll use the control unit on the hopper and these 2 levers to simply unwind the cable from the cable drum, which you can see at the top here. Now we can start unwinding the cable. I have 2 control levers at the control unit here. The left lever is for enablement. The right lever determines the direction of rotation of the drum. That's the electric cable connected. Now we need to switch off the intermediate gearbox. The feedback light is already off, and then we'll simply switch off the ignition completely. The truck is now switched off completely, and we can start to pump electrically. The cable is connected. Now there's voltage running through it. And it's as though the power takeoff is not engaged. Here we have our main switch. I simply actuate it. The lighting immediately comes on and the fan for the water cooling is running.